Quite a bombshell, don't you think? I was so young and innocent then, too. The whole thing hurt more than you can imagine. Still, c'est la vie. My father got off lightly. He did just what he wanted and then died, and left me to take the consequences. I'm the only one left for Marcello to hate now. In a way, I can't say I blame him, and it was probably good that we lived together. At least it gave him someone to take it all out on. It certainly added a bit of spice to the humdrum life at Maella Abbey, anyway.
Angelo, I'm so...
This story's gone on long enough. Look, it's nearly daybreak.
Wait!
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Are you feeling all right, Your Majesty? It's me, Emmer, the maid. I see you haven't eaten any of the lunch I brought you, Your Majesty. I'll be sure to bring you your favorite for supper. Please, Your Majesty, please answer me. I just want to make sure you're all right. Very well. I'll leave you in peace. Excuse me. He's hardly eating a thing either. And I could hear him weeping all through the night yesterday. He was such a benevolent and wise king when the queen was still alive. I'm terribly sorry I'm of so little use to him.
I see. So it continues. It must be difficult for you, Emma. But I need you to keep trying. If the king cannot recover from this, the country will fall apart. I just don't know what to suggest.
Ah, hello there. Do you seek an audience with the King of Ascanther? I'm afraid that His Majesty has been unavailable to visitors since the period of mourning for the late Queen began, 2 years ago. He comes down to the royal suite every night, but I doubt that he'll grant you an audience. I realize that that must seem strange to you, but if you return after dark, you'll see for yourselves.
Thank you.